Mathematics class 11 chapter 1 sets. In the last class we have completed exercise 1.6. We have also solved question number 13 to 16 of miscellaneous exercise. Today we shall study the rest of the questions on miscellaneous exercise. Question number 1. Decide among the following sets which are subsets of one another. So we are given 4 sets. Among them we have to write which are the subset of each other. Set A is given to us as x such that x belongs to R and x satisfies x square minus 8x plus 12 equal to 0. So x is a real number and x is a solution of this quadratic equation. So we shall solve the quadratic equation first. X square minus 8x plus 12 equal to 0. Split the middle term, factors out 12 to get 8, that is 6 and 2. So x square minus 6x minus 2x plus 12 equal to 0. From here take x common. Here x minus 6 minus, from here take 2 common, here x minus 6, because minus taking common, plus becomes minus. Here so factors are x minus 6, x minus 2 equal to 0. From here you get x value as 6 and from here x value 2. So the elements of set A are 6 and 2. I have written here A is equal to 2 and 6. B is given to you 2, 4, 6. C is given to us 2, 4, 6, 8 and D is given to you 6. Now among all these, the smallest set is D. So D and this element 6 is part of set A, set B and set C. That means you can say D is a subset of A, is a subset of B and is a subset of C. So D is subset of all. You can write separately also that D is subset of A, D is subset of B, D is subset of C. We can also see that this is 2 and 6. This 2 and 6 is part of B, 2 and 6. So we can also say that A is a subset of B. And this 2 and 6 is also part of set C, 2 and 6. So you can see A is a subset of C. And we can see B, 2, 4, 6. This is also part of set C, that is 2, 4, 6. And this is bigger set. So we can say that B is a subset of set C. So D subset of A, D subset of B, D subset of C. And A subset of B, A subset of C. And B is a subset of C. So these are the This is the solution for question number 1. Question number 2. In each of the following, determine whether the statement is true or false. If true, prove it. And false, give example. Roman number 1. If x belongs to A and A belongs to B, then x belongs to B. X is element of A and A is element of B, then x belongs to B. But this is not true, so this statement is false. If it is false, we have to give an example. So let us give an example. Let A is equal to singleton set X. Now according to given condition, this A should be part of B, element of B. So I take set B equal to singleton set X and Y. So this is A which is part of B. Okay. Now we can see that I have taken the set in such a way that X belongs to A, A belongs to B, but this X, the element of A, is not in B. This is a set, okay, but not element. So we can say X belongs to B. X does not belong to B. Roman number 2, if A subset of B, B belongs to C, then A belongs to C. This statement also is false. So we have to give example. Let A is equal to singleton set X. B is equal to X and Y. So here I am taking A subset of B because X is already in B. And we have to take B belongs to C. So this should be part of set C. So C is equal to X, Y, this B. And one more element I am taking as Z. So we can say that B belongs to C and A subset of B. But we can see that A does not belong to C. Why? Because this singleton set X is not part of this. So, but A does not belong to C. So, that is a solution for Roman number 2. Roman number 3, if A subset of B, B subset of C, then A subset of C, this is true. If it is true, we have to prove it. So, let us prove it. X belongs to A implies X belongs to B. Why? Because A subset of B. Again, B subset of C, that means X belongs to B. That means this X also is part of C. Why? B subset of C. Now we can see X belongs to A, X belongs to C. So if this condition is there, that means we can say A is a subset of C. Question number 4. If A not subset of B, B not subset of C, then A is not subset of C. But this statement is false. So we have to give an example. Let A is equal to XY, B is equal to ABX. So A is not subset of B. And C is equal to XYZ. So B is not subset of C. Then I have written here what is given, A subset, A not subset B, B not subset C. But we can see that this XY is part of C. So A subset of C. So this is false. Number 5, if x belongs to a and a is not subset of b, then x belongs to b. This is also false. So we have to give an example. Let us take set A is equal to x, y, z. B is equal to a, b, y, z. Then it is clear that a is not subset of b. X belongs to a and x does not belong to b. So x belongs to a but it is not belonging to b. You can see it is not here. So this statement is false. Number 6, if a subset of b and x does not belong to b, then x does not belong to a. This is true. Then we have to prove it. That x belongs to a implies x belongs to b. Why? Because a subset of b. Now if x does not belong to b, then obviously x will not belong to a. Question number 3, let a, b and c be the set such that, this symbol is such that a union b is equal to a union c and a intersection b is equal to a intersection c. Then show that b is equal to c. We have to prove this. Now for this I am going to use one property. Okay, the property is a is equal to a intersection a union b and a is equal to a union a intersection b. See, a union b, this union will be set of elements of a and elements of b and which is included in both. And if I find intersection of this set with a, then the answer will be set a. Same way for this, a intersection b means the common to both the sets, which the elements which are in set a and b. Okay, and now these common elements, if I do the union with a, the answer will be set a, the bigger set will be the answer. So I'm going to use these two properties and solve the given question. So using this, I'm writing b equal to, instead of a I'm writing b union a intersection b. Okay, I have written this for a, same way we can write for b. But then you see here a, then a twice. Okay, the twice more, that is the answer. So here b and b. Now we are given in the equation that a intersection b is equal to a intersection c. So instead of a intersection b, put a intersection c. Okay, now we open the bracket. So b union a intersection b union c. Now a union b, in the equation it is given a union c. Okay, given a union b is equal to a union c. Okay, this part. So put the value, instead of a union b, a union c. And this I just keep as it is. I just rearrange this c union a intersection c union b. So I'm going to use the property, or you can say that I'm taking c common. Okay, here I have distributed union over the intersection, here I am taking common. Okay, the opposite of this. So take c common, so you get here union a intersection b. C union b, c union a, so union will come here and a intersection b will come here. Okay, so that is what. Now a intersection b is given to us, a intersection c. Okay, it is given to us in the question a intersection b is equal to a intersection c. So you put a intersection c. Now again I am going to use this property, a equal to a union a intersection c. So a, so answer is a. Here c union a intersection c, so c and c, so answer of this will be c. So this value is equal to c, and here from here it is b, so b equal to c, hence proved. Question number 4, show that following four conditions are equivalent. So they are equal, we have to show. So first one is a subset b, second is a minus b equal to 5, 3 is a union b equal to b, and fourth is a intersection b is equal to a. So these four are equal, we have to prove that. So I'll prove 1 implies 2 first. So a minus b, this means by definition x says that x belongs to a but x does not belong to b. Since a subset of b, a minus b is equal to 5. Why? Because a is part of b and a minus b means elements of a but not in b. But a subset of b means all the elements of a should be in b. That means a minus b will be empty set. 2 implies 3, a minus b equal to 5 from here. This means a subset of b. And this means if I take a union b, answer will be the bigger set, so b. 3 implies 4, a union b is equal to b from here, implies a subset of b. If a subset of b, that means a intersection b is equal to a. Intersection, then the smaller set will be the answer. 4 implies 1, a intersection b is equal to a, this one. And it is obvious if intersection of two set is a, then that set will be the subset of the other one. So a subset of b. So from here we can say that 1 double implies 2, double implies 3, double implies 4. So we can say all four conditions are equivalent. Question number 5. Show that if a subset of b, then c minus b subset of c minus a. Let us start from here, x belongs to c minus b. x belongs to c minus b means by definition x belongs to c and x does not belong to b. Okay, now from here we can say x belongs to c. We are given a subset of b. That means if x does not belong to b, x will not belong to a also. Okay, how we prove this? X, if a subset of b, x does not belong to b implies x does not belong to a. So same way, if here a subset of b, if x does not belong to b, it will not belong to a as a subset of b. So that means this can be written as x belongs to c minus a. And what we have proved, x belongs to c minus b implies x belongs to c minus a. So we can say that c minus b subset of c minus a. So that is the solution for question number 5. Question number 6, assume that power set of a equal to power set of b. Show that a equal to b. Let x belongs to a. Power set means the set, all the subset of this set a. So that is singleton. Here I am taking one element, so I will take singleton x. This is element belonging to power set of a. We are given p of a is equal to p of b. So this is equal to p of b. This means x belongs to b. X belongs to a implies x belongs to b. That means a subset of b, call it number 1. Let x belongs to b from opposite side. This means power set of b, that is root square set x, is a part of b of power set of b. Power set of b given to us equal to a. This means x belongs to a. That means b subset of a. From 1 and 2, we can say that a subset of b, b subset of a, double implies a equal to b. Hence, prove that is the solution for question number 6. Question number 7. Is it true that for any sets A and B, power of A union power of B is equal to power of A union B? This is not true. Okay, justify your answer. No, it is not true. So we have to justify. We shall justify by giving an example. So I consider set A is equal to X and Y, set B is Y and Z, and A union B is X, Y, Z. Okay, if I find union X, Y, Y, Z, so X, Y, Z. We don't repeat the same element. Power set of A, singleton X, singleton y, set a itself and empty set phi. Power set of b, singleton y, singleton z, set b itself and phi. And let us find the union of these two. Power set of a, union power set of b. That means all the elements of this set and all the elements of the second set. So what remains here? X, y, y is already there. So here z, a phi and b phi. So a b phi. Okay, call it number 1. Now let us find the power set of this one, A union B. So power set of A union B is equal to singleton X, singleton Y, singleton Z, then XY, YZ and XZ. Then A union B set itself, so XYZ and empty set phi. Now you can see 1 and 2, they are not equal, right? Since they are not equal, we can say from 1 and 2, power of A union power of B is not equal to power set of A union B. Hence proved, or hence justified. Question number 8. Show that for any sets A and B, A is equal to A intersection B union A minus B and A union B minus A equal to A union B. We'll prove the first one first. So I'll take X belonging to this side, that is right hand side. X belongs to A intersection B union A minus B. By definition, union means X belongs to this or X belongs to this or X belongs to both. So X belongs to A intersection B or X belongs to A minus B. This means intersection means X belongs to A and X belongs to B. And this means X belongs to A but X does not belong to B. So from these two, what we can say that see, X does not belong to B, here belongs to B, that means X belongs to A. And if I double imply, that means if X belongs to A gives you X belongs to A intersection B union A minus B. So we can say that using this, that if A subset of B, B subset of A, A and B are same. So if I prove from here, A subset of this, and if you prove from here, this is subset of A. So we can say this and this are same. So we can say A intersection B union A minus B equal to A. Now the part 2, A union B minus A equal to A union B. So let us start in the same manner. X is belongs to this side, left hand side, X A union B minus A. Union means X belongs to A or here, B minus A. And B minus A means X belongs to B and X does not belong to A. And this means, these two conditions means that X belongs to A union B. If I double imply, then I will get A union B subset of this one. So we can say these two are equal. Question number 9. Using properties of set, show that A union A intersection B is equal to A. Okay, the same one which we have used here. Okay, what I have used here, the second one. Okay, but now we have to prove it. X belongs to, I start first, this proof is for the both the questions. Okay, X belongs to A union A intersection B. That means X belongs to A or X belongs to A intersection B. Intersection means X belongs to both. This means A subset of B. Now, this we will use to prove number 1 also and 2 also. So, left hand side I take of the number 1, that is A union A intersection B. Okay, I'll open this. So, A union A intersection A union B. Okay, A union A is A. A union B is A. Oh, sorry, it is not A, it should be B. A union B. Okay, A union B means the when union you are taking, then a bigger set will be the answer. Now A subset of B means B is a subset, bigger set. So this will be B. Okay, this will be not A, will be B. A union B is B. A intersection B will be A. Okay, the smaller set will be for intersection, bigger set will be for union. But A intersection B will be A because A is a subset of B. So A intersection B will be A union B will be B. Okay, so that is make the correction. So we have shown equal to right hand side. Question number 2, A intersection A union B equal to A. So I use left hand side, A intersection A union B. First you open the bracket, so A intersection A union A intersection B. A intersection B, already I told you A intersection is B is A because why? A subset of B. So this value is A, this value also is A, A union A is A. Hence we have proved this equal to this. Question number 10, show that A intersection B is equal to A intersection C need not imply B equal to C. So I will solve this by taking an example. Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 3, 4, 5. C is equal to 3, 7, 8. I have not taken B and C equal. Okay. But we will show that A intersection B and A intersection C is same. So let us find A intersection B. So among these two, the common one is only 3. So singletons are 3. Now A intersection C. So here 1, 2, 3, here 3, 7, 8. So 3 is common to both. So intersection of A and C is singleton 3. So we have showed both answers are same. Intersection of A with B and A with C is same. But we have seen that we have taken B and C different. Here 3, 4, 5, here 3, 7, 8. So but B not equal to C. So hence proved. Question number 11. Let A and B be sets if A intersection X equal to B intersection X equal to 5 and A union X is equal to B union X for some set X. Show that A equal to B. So this hint they have given us. Otherwise also I am going to use this one same what we have used here. Okay. So that is the one we are starting with. So A equal to A intersection A union X. Okay. We are given that A union X is equal to B union X. Okay, given the question. So instead of A union X, put B union X. Open this bracket. So A intersection B union A intersection X. A intersection X is again given to us as B intersection X. Okay, this one given in the question. So use that. Now from here, you can take B common. So you can take B common. So B intersection. See B intersection with A, B intersection with X. So B intersection will come and A union X will come here. Okay. Now A union X again in the given A union X is B union X. So instead of A union X, put B union X. Open the bracket. So B intersection B union B intersection X. But B intersection X is given to you 5. So put the value B intersection X as 5. B union 5 will be B and this side is A. So A equal to B. Hence proved. So that is the solution for question number 11. Question number 12. Find sets A, B and C such that A intersection B, B intersection C and A intersection C are non-empty sets and A intersection B intersection C equal to 5. This can be any, you can make a number of A and B and C. So I have just taken one example. A is equal to XY I am taking, B is equal to XZ, C equal to YZ. You can take 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, something you can take. You can take either these. Let us, we have to show A intersection B, B intersection C, S intersection C is non-empty. So some answer should be there, some element should be there. And if you do intersection of all three, then it is empty set. So let us find A intersection B. So A intersection B, we can see X is a common element, so X. Find B intersection C, here Z is a common, so Z. so it is non-empty. And A intersection C, so here Y is the common, so Y. So these all in three intersection are non-empty sets. Let us find A intersection B intersection C. So this intersection, this C I'm just keeping as it is. So intersection of these two is X and C set is YZ. Now you can see X, YZ, there is no common in this both the sets. So answer is 5. Okay, so we can show that though A intersection B, B intersection C, A intersection C is non-empty, but if you do intersection of all three equal to 5, you can find A, B, C, such a kind, many. Okay, so here we complete exercise, miscellaneous exercise, plus we complete the chapter 1. Thank you very much.